I'm going to show you how to make boring photos interesting using the PowerDirector mobile video editor app. Let's get moving. As you can see, I have some photos on the overlay track of the timeline, and I want to use four tricks to animate these photos and bring them to life. We'll start off with a zoom. So this can be used to zoom in or zoom out based on what you want to do with your image. We'll go ahead and tap the first image, and we're going to tap on transform keyframe. At this point, we're going to tap on add keyframe, and here you can pinch out to scale it up, or you can just go ahead and type in what you want your scale to be. So if you tap on scale, you can type it in and hit done. And then you want to move your playhead to the end of the clip. Then you'll tap on add keyframe. And then you can go ahead and pinch in. Or once again, you can go ahead and change the scale by tapping on scale and typing in the parameters you want. And hitting done. Next, we'll do a diagonal slide. This can be done in any direction based on your preference. So we want to tap on the next clip. We want to tap on transform keyframe. And we want to tap on add keyframe. Once again, you can pinch out to raise the scale up. Or you can tap on scale and type in what you want. We're going to make this 2 and hit done. And then we need to move it over and up a little bit. So we're going to tap on the position X. And we're going to type in 1 and hit done. Then we're going to tap on position Y. And we'll hit 0 and hit done. We'll move our playhead to the end of the clip. We'll tap on add keyframe. We'll tap on the X position. We'll change it to 0. Hit done. And then we'll tap on the Y position. We're going to change that to 1 and hit done. And this will make it slide from the bottom left corner all the way up to the top right corner. Now we're going to make a photo rotate. So we're going to tap on the next photo. We're going to tap on transform keyframe. We'll tap on add keyframe. And we can pinch out to whatever scale we want, or we can type it in. So I'm going to tap on scale, change it to 2, and hit done. Then we're going to move our playhead to the end of the clip. And we're going to tap on rotation. And we'll type in 360 and hit done. And this will make the clip rotate all the way around 360 degrees. We'll cap off this session by doing a lateral slide. This can be done to the left or right based on your needs. So we're going to tap on the next photo. We're going to tap on transform keyframe. And then we're going to tap on add a keyframe. At this point, we can pinch out to whatever size we want. In this case, we're going to tap on scale. We're going to change it to 1.5 and hit done. Then we're going to tap on position X. And we're going to type in 0.750 and hit done. And you see it moves everything over to the right. Now we'll move our playhead to the end of the clip. We'll tap on add keyframe. And we're going to tap on position X. We're going to change that to 0.250 and hit done. And that'll move everything over to the other side. Now we can play all of these back and show you the fruits of our labor. Animation rules the nation. You can create an even more complex photo animation by watching this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.